Alright guys, we are at the end of the day today, and it was a wonderful day. We had a lot of lasers and fillers in the morning, and then I filmed the doctor's show this afternoon. And then I came and I got to see one of my beautiful patients who's thankful enough to let us film. And the reason I think it's great that we're showing this is we're doing a combination treatment for a very common condition that a lot of patients have as they age, especially my lighter skinned patients with lighter eye color, lighter hair color. They get a lot of redness that appears out of nowhere. And sometimes it's hormonally related, sometimes it's sun from over time, years before, or sometimes it's just genetic and frank bad luck. And so what we're using right now is something called Aerolase. This is the first step in my process for her of doing a combination of things to make her skin quality better, to prevent skin cancer and remove sun damage, but also decrease the redness, okay? This is a microsecond YAG laser, which means that the laser is actually going very deep into the skin and heating it. So do you feel heat? Yeah. But it's not burning the surface, which is really amazing. This type of technology, a YAG, typically doesn't do that. It usually burns the surface. So what this allows us to do is it basically tells the body's blood vessels and pigmentation to get removed, to lift to the surface. And so we do it in a pattern area. So we follow these passes. And this Aerolase device is really unique. What's great about it, depending on the settings, is you can treat redness, you can treat hair, you can do hair removal, you can do skin tightening and rejuvenation, you can do blood vessel removal, and you can treat pigmentation and melasma, as well as scars. So there's a lot of things you can do. So this is our first step. We preheat the skin to get these blood vessels stimulated. This can just happen, unfortunately. And unfortunately, no matter what you do, you're going to have ongoing treatments forever. We try and make as much improvement as we can in the first 3 to 6 treatments. Turn your head all the way to the left. And she's actually made major headways. You know, when someone looks at themselves every day, they see all this. But when she came in originally, she was bright red. I mean, literally. Now, it's just subtle, normal. And we, you know, this can be done very frequently, actually. We can have patients do this with their facials. We call it a laser facial. And that can be done every couple weeks if they want it, to just speed up the process and keep it really under control. The second step in our process is going to be to do direct vascular laser treatment. After about 150 pulses, we have to wait a second because the skin heats up. You can feel the difference. It's pretty dramatic. When I cool down for a few minutes, this is a solid state laser, so it requires that. Second step in the process will be to use a true vascular laser, which focuses a little more superficially in the skin to all these little dilated vessels. If you come in really close, you can see some small dilated vessels here. These are what we call telangiectasia, matte telangiectasia, diffuse sort of redness. When we treat those, we're going to treat those independently with what's called the XLV laser, but you can also treat that with other lasers like IPL, the Venus Versa, yellow laser, or pulse dye laser. We happen to have all of those. These are the most targeted. This is also the most safe. I want to keep her safe just like I would treat my mom. This is how I'm going to treat her. So we don't want to burn. She gets very nervous. Mm-hmm. We're going to make sure we treat, you know. And then the best thing that she's also getting with the Aerolase, she's getting some skin tightening. So to me, she's getting an anti-aging effect, which I'm very happy with. I want her to get, feel more youthful, you know. The skin changes in women very frequently in the 35 to 45 range and older because hormones change. And unfortunately, it has a huge effect on the skin. Not only with skin laxity, but also with blood vessels and pigmentation. So you really need to rejuvenate it. You know, doing things like micro-rolling at home, retinol masks to stimulate exfoliation. For her, we have to be really careful about her skincare products, which is very sensitive. So we have to use very specific products. So we're using things like Restore-C, which is a fish enzyme product that helps calm the skin. Something called MD Rejuvena, which is a chlorophyll-based product, which is organic and natural, and calms the skin down. It has a pore reducer and a redness reducer that's really great. But what's amazing is, you guys, look, we're on the second pass, and already the redness has decreased. How's the heat?
It's hotter than last
before,
time.
Before, yeah, because we went up.
Yep.
But it's not terrible.
No.
Okay,
it's
good.
It's tolerable.
But you know it's there.
Yep.
And what's amazing, when we look at your skin, nothing's happening. When I look at you right now, it looks like nothing's happening. But you know stuff is happening because you feel the heat. Because it's bypassing the top level of the skin, and it's going deeper below the surface to stimulate skin tightening and to shrink, and then to shrink the blood vessels. The other benefit is women sometimes get a few hairs as they age, you know, on the chin and mouth area. We're going to get rid of those.
Yay.
Those will go away with the air lays.
Yay.
I know. Everyone hates those. It's true. So we're going to do one more pass. See that? You guys saw that hair just disappear right there? See? You probably felt that a little more.
Mm-hmm.
And look, right there, hair. Let's go back. Let's see it again. Okay. Bam. Got the hair. Everything's doing great. You just get nice, mild redness. It's exactly what we want. You want to build up that heat under the surface. When you have acne, some people call this NeoClear treatment, but regardless, whatever, this is a heating type of laser that's very focused on specific things like redness, acne, pigmentation, fine lines and tightening. A lot of my celebrities do this treatment because they literally walk out of here looking fine and they go right to Equinox. Totally fine. Isn't that crazy? I know. No issues. They want stuff that can help them without having a lot of downtime. I'll turn all the way to the right. We're going to the other side. Key to this treatment is patience. You have to have patience. You've got to go nice and slow. Nice overlap. Again, we wait after about 150-200 pulses. Let it cool down. I can feel over here very hot. That's
mm-hmm.
great. We love that. I wish you guys could feel this. Because it doesn't even look like anything happened. You know what I mean? Almost looks like nothing happened. But she's got an amazing outcome. So, and even the forehead's still warm, which is great.
Mm-hmm.
So that means we know it's working. Okay, now we go back. Mm-hmm. 90 degrees. Each pulse delivering a nice amount of energy. Again, we're going to get some of those hairs. See, I'm sorry, we're getting those. See those hairs going away, you guys? You can see them, they're smoking up. They hurt a little bit, right?
Yeah.
But it's not terrible.
Yes.
I know. This actually laser was designed for darker skin, so my Middle Eastern patients love this laser, and my Hispanic, they can have hairs, because they can use this without burning their skin, which is amazing.
It is.
A lot of lasers, like the Alexes and the Diodes, even though they say they can use them on dark skin, we've seen many times issues in patients. Again, going over the gel area a little bit more to get some skin tightening. Because she's here, we might as well give her that, you know. Even though the focus is mainly redness, we still want to make her skin look better and be healthier and be tighter. Anyone asking anything? Instagram?
For people tuning in, which one serves it?
So this is the Aerolase Microsecond YAG laser. The key point about this is it's delivering a lot of energy under the skin without you even noticing, because it's not burning the surface. So you can even see when we go over the hairs, you can see the smoke, right? It's working. You know it's working. You want that?
Yeah.
We'll do your next. It is next.
Bring all my hair off.
What?
Bring all my hair off.
I know. That's what all my dark skinned women say. Get rid of those hairs. No, and this removes pigmentation. So if you have pigmentation in hair follicles or in acne, this is the treatment. It's awesome. So we want to heat so you can feel it. I'm going to feel your skin.
Mm-hmm.
Very warm. That's
yeah.
great. That's what we want. That's perfect. And the response she's getting is perfect. What are you saying?
Can it be used for scars?
It can, but it has to be in a different setting. We would preheat with this laser, with this tip, and then we would go to the 2mm focus tip and blast the scar. Turns very dark black and blue. Remember, the key word is patience. Nice and slow. Work pass. Again, getting those hairs over time. If you do the lip, it plumps the lip up. Sorry. It heats up a little too, but it plumps it. So we're getting all that redness. Beautiful. One more pass. And then she's done. It's about a 10-15 minute treatment or so. And then we're going to move into step two.
Does she need numbing cream?
With this one, you usually don't. You're going to another 150. You're going to wait about 10 seconds and feel your skin. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. With this one, you don't. But because we're doing a combination of things, we are using the numbing cream today. But I like people actually not to have much numbing cream with this because I want to know what they feel. Because if it gets too hot, you want to bring it down. Because heat can build up in the surface and cause blisters and burns. With any laser, regardless of how safe the laser is in general.
Does it affect filler that's in the...
Not at all. If anything, I think it helps it a little bit because of collagen production. And decreases swelling if they're swelling from fillers.
You need to do this as a series?
Yeah, I mean, this is something I tell people to do monthly when they do facials, but if we're treating rosacea, we do it in a series of 3 to 6 of them, and then we get on a maintenance plan. Perfect. So, diffuse redness is done. That's the underlying, we call it preheating, global targeting. Okay, and now we're going to move to our focus heating. Okay, so this is, now we're on focus targeting. Is my
sound on? Yeah, you're good.
Okay, now we're doing focus targeting. I'm going to do a pulse so you know what it's like. 1, 2, 3. Okay. So now we're going to do focus targeting. What this is focusing on the actual more superficial redness, not as deep. Okay, and we're targeting those dilated vessels that you hate.
This may be the screen.
This is the, what?
So, I don't think we should use this. This laser?
No, this doesn't. It doesn't really do it.
Really?
I swear.
Okay, just confirming.
Blinks?
Yeah.
Well, like green like flashes.
Okay.
Like that.
Did anything happen to it?
No, nothing's happened to it. It
no.
just went pink.
It just.
It does that sometimes. Maybe okay. Stand back just a little
yeah,
bit.
Yeah.
Okay, so now we're doing focus targeting with the XLV. And this is a vascular laser we call a KTP. It also has a YAG on it, but different type. Regardless, we're focusing on big problem areas of her redness, the flushing and the blushing, okay? This is significantly decreased, although people that have dilated, small dilated vessels, not much. And we're targeting those diffuse areas. This hurts or no? How does it feel?
Yeah, I can feel it.
But it's not terrible.
No, it's not terrible.
That's the thing. That's what I always tell people. And we're just trying to get nice calming of these superficial vessels and focusing on areas where that really bother her, where there's typical redness and rosacea or flushing and blushing, cheeks, chin, and nose, sometimes forehead. She's also getting some in her eyebrow, which is called causing some thinning of her brow. So we're going to focus on treating that separately with topicals. And you can see, I mean, with this, I'm also using a polarized headlight. That allows me to really visualize the blood vessels. It's really important when you use these, you have this type of headlight. Honestly, any doctor, and I know now it's going to make the company go up in price, but any doctor that does vascular laser without this headlamp is underselling their patients. Because I can literally visualize the blood vessels disappearing and shrinking immediately. You can't see that with your normal eye. You just can't. Okay, now we're going to go to the second side. They're all responding fantastically. Our focused targeting. The first layer was deeper, global heating, calming everything down. Second layer. Facial redness, this is an ongoing battle, okay? So in general, you're gonna need a series of treatments and then turn to the right. Ongoing treatments are gonna be at least a few times a year. Everybody is different. Some people it's more, some people it's less. But in general, you're gonna need all the time. But we typically say the first 3 to 6 treatments are closer together. Once you improve, we shrink it. Now, we're going to change the setting to just get the little baby blood vessels she has on her nose and on the center part of her face. So, we're going to go right in there. There's one right there. Go right in there, just bam. We're going to hit it. Turn blue. Okay, same thing. We're going to go right in there, turn blue. And that's what I can see with my polarized light. We're going to get some of these larger vessels. Smaller focus, okay? I'm gonna spot treat those guys. Turn to the left for me, okay? Sometimes this makes a little black and blue, but we get a much better result if we do it. So we suffer through it. Okay, see that? See those blood vessels right here on the nose? You see those right there? I'll show you guys those right through the window, right here. Hit those, 2, 3, bam. Look at that, disappeared. See? Same thing, 1, 2, 3, bam. Good. All gone. Turn to the right a little bit. Let's take a look on this side, same thing. See those vessels there? They're small. They've shrunk. So we're going to go right in there. Sorry, we're going right on into your nose. Number one, hit down. Beautiful. Very good. All right, we look at the chin. Okay, so we're going to hit some of those independent vessels. See all these with my light. Yes. Okay, good. Now, that's step two of focus targeting. Now we're going to go to step three, which is going to be overall facial rejuvenation with non-ablative resurfacing. We're going to use a low-energy laser to calm her skin down and also improve the sun damage, clear and brilliant. Alright, so we're now on to step three of our decreased redness, improved pores, and sun damage on my patient's face. I do this every month to myself, actually. This is clear and brilliant. This is our favorite baby laser in our practice. Why is it called a baby laser? because this is very low energy, low density. And what that means is not a lot of downtime, but it still has the capacity to go to the level that we want to improve sun damage, to bring up pigmentation, to calm down redness, and decrease pore size. Actually, a lot of study that was done a couple years ago when this first came out in 3 treatments showed a 19% reduction in pores. So, you know, obviously nothing's forever, so this is more, because it's low energy, something you need to do a little more often to get improvement, but you can space it out. You start the first 3 a little closer together, then the next 3 a little bit longer. An average, I tell people, 4 to 6 weeks for average rejuvenation, 2 to 3 weeks if you have really bad pigmentation. This handpiece, which is the Promeo wavelength, is more superficial and broad, so this treats more discoloration and superficial issues like the diffuse redness that she has, versus the original, which is deeper, that could be used for lines and wrinkles, although, and scars, but although they both treat both, this just does the superficial a little bit more. So discoloration, pores, texture, she's gonna see more of an improvement with the Promea. How are you doing?
Great, good.
Describe the feeling of it, because a lot of people, I get all different things.
Oh.
I get electrical shocks, I get scratching on the face, I get lick. That's what I've heard many times.
I think it's more like a cat's lick.
Cat's lick.
It doesn't hurt.
I know, what is it? It's like sandpaper, kind of?
Yeah, it's sandpaper.
So that's where I get that. I don't know my cat fans, but I hear this all the time, cat's lick. So
yeah.
Whoever has a cat understands they don't have wet tongues. So.
Oh, absolutely.
You know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah.
I'm definitely allergic to cats, so if he licks me, I'm dead. That's all I have to say. So if you do not send cats to my house, it's really bad. But in general, that's what I get. I've gotten like crazy things. The women think it's almost nothing. The men always think it's worse than it is. So
well.
I don't know. I have 2 men that won't do any numbing with it. Turn your head all the way to the left for me. And they don't mind. They say it's nothing. And then I have some people that think it's the end of the world. So...
No, it doesn't hurt. I don't think it hurts at all.
Good. Well, you're a strong woman. So
yes.
Who knows? I don't know.
Absolutely.
I need to give all my women that have Duclair and Brilliant a shirt that says, I'm a strong woman.
Yes.
Exactly. So, basically, and the other thing that's cool about the Promea, come in close and listen. What does that sound like? You guys all know what that sounds like. Movie night, right?
Yes.
Popcorn in the microwave. You hear it?
Yeah.
It's popping. Here we go. Listen. Why is that? Because it's taking out the hydration in the upper surface and putting the energy in, so it creates a popping noise as the microscopic channels go into the skin. With the original, which is much deeper, you don't hear that at all. So you hear that? You want to hear that little scraping. You hear that? You hear it? Not this machine, the actual skin. You gotta hear it really up close. You hear it? It's a little popcorning. It's like I'm at home on the weekend. Gonna watch a movie.
Every night.
I know, I do that every night on Amazon. I've seen every
popcorn.
Amazon. Oh, you eat popcorn?
Oh, we're talking about popcorn.
Really?
Yeah.
Every day.
Which kind? Do you like the kettle popcorn or the regular?
Orville Redenbacher.
Oh,
movie standard butter.
Well, that's really fattening. Not even the reduced fat? You're talking about the regular? Oh, good for you. Do you have, though, if you like popcorn, do you have the little powders that you put into it?
Oh my god,
those
are
the best.
Are you serious?
So
the ranch popcorn, the ranch powder, the cheese powder.
I like the cheese.
Chive powder.
I got them at the movie theater.
Do they have a Cheetos powder?
I think they do.
I probably do.
Yeah.
So let's get back to topic. Sorry, guys. We're all hungry. So as you see, as we roll across the skin, take a look. There's just redness that increases. This is good. This is erythema from inflammation that's under the surface. But again, because it's low density and not a high density, this treatment can be done on all skin types, including darker skin. You can treat black skin with this laser. Without really any issues on the surface, which is really great. And what you do wanna see is kinda highlighting of the brown spots. So a lot of her brown spots become much more apparent. That's because this wavelength's more superficial and it's pulling the pigment, it's attracting the pigment. You could spot treat those brown spots right now if you wanted, or we could go to a stronger laser in the future, such as Fraxel, that may irritate her rosacea a little bit. So that's why we're doing a low energy laser. Any questions on IG?
Yeah,
Which company makes this?
This is the Clear and Brilliant by Valiant.
Can you talk about the three treatments combined?
Yeah, I mean, this is by Emmer's combination for facial redness, rosacea, anti-aging. We use Aerolaze deep heating to tighten the skin and remove some more of the redness and browns. We then go more superficial with the KTP XLV to remove focal targeting of blood vessels and really target the rosacea even more. And then we globally treat the entire area for sun damage and redness with the non-ablative resurfacing, which could include Clear and Brilliant, Venus Viva, or microneedling radio frequency if you wanted to. Those three options are best. Turn all the way to the right. Then you can maintain these results with a Pico Focus treatment in the future, laser genesis, and more Aerolases, or you just continue these treatments every month or two. As you improve, you need less of them. But you know, we do the best we can and see how well someone's skin responds. We're doing everything we can. Do you see, you hear the little popping sound. This is fantastic. She's got her fan helping the process move along. You gotta have patience with this treatment as well, because you want this to be nice and smooth. The one thing about this type of laser, this is called optical scanning. So as you roll, it delivers the holes in the skin evenly. Unlike stamping devices where you go poom, 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 you can move your hand, you can move, they can overlap. Those cause, you have to be much more careful about how you apply. With this, it's evenly distribution of energy, homogeneous delivery of energy, which makes it very safe. Really, I've never seen a complication from this ever. And the only time I've ever seen somebody worsen from their melasma was when they had this treatment done, they went directly in the sun and they lied to me. So, if you follow my protocols and you follow what we need to do regularly, you will not worsen, you will improve. You know, the thing is, skin is like working out. You have to go every day, you have to do something every day. Otherwise, your body gets out of shape. Same thing with the skin. If you don't do something every day, your skin gets out of shape. You know, anytime you get melasma, flares, or anytime you get, you know, like let's say a mark that's found on the skin, typically that's from like if you were running too fast and you sprained your ankle, or you got out of the car too quickly and you closed the door on your finger, like that type of thing. That's because you picked your skin and you got an acne mark, or that's because you didn't wear sunscreen and it causes sunburn, which caused your melasma to flare. In general, if you're following the daily maintenances, you're gonna be fine. So it's really important to make it a lifestyle, part of your lifestyle. Which is what we're doing here. It's doing great. Now I'm gonna go all the way up into the ear. I'm gonna really treat those ear wrinkles. Nice coverage there. I'm gonna help the eye wrinkles here. Going really good over the blood vessels. We want this nice diffuse redness, which we're then going to treat with some LED therapy, red light therapy, which is step 4, to have her calm everything down. Can you give me the bipolar cautery so I can burn the little spot that she has? Almost done. And you can see almost immediately the pores reduce, which is really great.
What laser light energy is used?
What laser? This is a diode laser at a 1927 wavelength. That's why you don't see it. So we're gonna use a bipolar cautery, basically done right now, 3 more seconds with the Clear and Brilliant, and then I'm gonna just buzz the little spot she has. Now, some people get dilated, sweat glands. We call them sebaceous hyperplasia. That's what she has under her eye here, so I'm rolling over that area a little bit more, kind of shrink those things down. But some people also get these little scaly spots on the skin. They pop up out of nowhere. Those are called actinic keratoses or precancers. They have the chance, very low percent, less than 0.1% chance of becoming a skin cancer if you treat them. So we're basically releasing all of those from the skin by doing the Clear and Brilliant, and then we're gonna isolate treatment onto that spot. So a lot of people use liquid nitrogen. I find that it can leave white spots on the skin and form blisters. We like to do old school bipolar cautery to those individual spots, or a laser on them. Remember, this is making little baby holes in the skin. That's gonna help our skin rejuvenate. So now, perfect. We're going to, individual, you're gonna feel a little burn, okay, for 1 second. Just gonna do on the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Good, again. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Almost done. Now, if this recurs, we'd wanna do a little biopsy on it. Now, perfect. I'm gonna just laser really quickly right over that. Hold on. So this could be just a little precancer, but if it recurs, you want to do a little biopsy of it. That's all. We're going to laser right on top of it to decrease any chance of that becoming a skin cancer. Good. And then now we're going to put some medicine on and put a mask. Go ahead and describe what you're doing, Michaela.
Okay. So I'm going to place some vitamins on you. It's going to help you.
So we're putting vitamins, vitamin B and C, to rehydrate the skin and protect the skin with antioxidants. Calms down the redness and treats, is really good for healing after non-ablative fractional laser like Clear and Brilliant. And then we cool the skin using
a crystal fiber mask.
Our crystal fiber mask, which helps penetrate the product and calm everything down. Overall, ultimate treatment. Perfect.